गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ अवर थर्ड लेक्चर फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर 6, दैट इज़ बायो मॉलिक्यूल्स। नाउ इन थर्ड लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज़ प्रोटीन्स। सो यू आर लुकिंग ऑन द स्क्रीन अवर टॉपिक प्रोटीन्स। टर्म प्रोटीन कम्स फ्रॉम लैटिन वर्ड प्रोटियस, which means first or primary important. Its importance is suggested by scientist Berzelius in 1830. Then scientist Mulder used term protein for complex organic nitrogenous substances. That substances are found in animal and plant cell. Now we will see about our next topic, that is characteristics of proteins. What are the characteristics of proteins which are shown? We will discuss here one by one. So number one, proteins are large molecules, consist of amino acid units ranging from 100 to 3000 units with high molecular weight. Number two, amino acids link together by peptide bonds and forms polypeptide chains. It contain any or all of 20 naturally occurring amino acid types. Number third characteristics, linear sequence of amino acids in polypeptide chain forms primary structure of protein. So primary structure is looking just like a chain structure. And functional proteins have three-dimensional conformation. Number fourth characteristics, some proteins, for example keratin protein found in hairs, consist of polypeptide chain arranged like spiral helix. If these spirals are in right-handed, called alpha helix, and if in left-handed, called beta helix. This spiral configuration is held together by hydrogen bonds. Next characteristics, due to formation of hydrogen bonds, peptide chain forms a secondary structure. In case of some proteins, two or more peptide chains are linked together by intermolecular hydrogen bonds and forms pleated sheet, for example found in silk fiber. Next characteristic, in large proteins, for example myoglobin found in muscle cells and enzymes, we know that there are different kinds of enzymes, peptide chains are much looped, twisted and folded back on themselves. Due to formation of disulfide bonds, such loops and bonds gives tertiary structure to proteins. So this type of protein structure we are calling tertiary structure. Next characteristics, in hemoglobin of RBCs, protein subunits are held together to form quaternary structure. So structure of hemoglobin is nothing but we can say as a quaternary structure of protein. So these are the different kinds of protein: primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. Now next characteristics is, protein shows amphoteric nature, which means they act as acid and base also. Its behavior is strongly influenced by pH. Next characteristic, like amino acid, proteins are dipolar ions at the isoelectric point, means positive and negative charges are equal and net charge is zero. Next one, proteins consist of more basic amino acids such as lysine, arginine, exist as cation but behaves as base at pH 7.4. So these proteins are called basic proteins. For example, histone proteins of nucleoproteins. Next characteristics, if proteins rich in acidic amino acids exist as anions and behaves as acid, such proteins are called acidic proteins. So these are the different characteristics we have seen of proteins. Now we will see our next topic, that is classification of proteins. So here we will discuss about classification of proteins. On the screen you are looking, classification of proteins on the basis of structure. Proteins are classified into following major three categories. Number one, simple proteins. So here on the screen you are looking, first type of protein, that is simple protein. On hydrolysis, it gives only amino acids which are soluble in one or more solvents and may soluble in water also. For example, histones, soluble in water. Globular molecule of histones are not coagulated by heat. Albumin, protein also soluble in water but can coagulated on heating, found in eggs, serum of blood cells, that we are calling serum albumin. Next example is legumulin, found in different kinds of pulses. So these are the some examples of simple proteins. Now we will see about conjugated protein. The next type of protein is conjugated proteins. On the screen you are looking, conjugated proteins. We will see about conjugated proteins now. These proteins are united with some non-protein part called prosthetic group. For example, HB means hemoglobin. Globin is the protein and iron is heme-containing pigment, is a prosthetic group. Similarly, nuclear proteins have nucleic acid as prosthetic group, and on the basis of prosthetic group, these proteins are classified as glycoproteins, mucoproteins, lipoproteins, etc. Mucoproteins found in saliva and heparin of blood. Lipoproteins means lipid containing proteins, etc. So these are the some examples of conjugate protein, which containing protein part and other non-protein part that we are calling prosthetic groups. For example, glycoprotein, lipoprotein, mucoprotein, etc. So here we have discussed about conjugated proteins. Now we will see the last category of proteins, that is derived proteins. So here we will discuss about now derived proteins. These proteins are not found in nature. Actually, these proteins are derived from native proteins molecules by hydrolysis. For example, metaproteins, peptones, etc. So these are the derived proteins. Here we have discussed about proteins, classification of proteins with their examples. Now on the screen you are looking some questions. After reading or after doing conversation with your subject teacher, you have to solve the questions which are present on the screen. Number one, all proteins are made up of the same amino acids. Then how proteins found in human beings and animals may be different from those of other? Number two, what are conjugated proteins? How do they differ from simple ones? Give examples of conjugated proteins. Next question, which of the following is simple protein? Options are nucleoprotein, mucoprotein, chromoprotein or globulin. So here very simple questions are you are looking on the screen. You have to solve these questions and show your teachers. If you are getting any problem, then contact your teacher. So here we have discussed about our next topic, that is proteins, types of proteins, its characteristics and various kinds of examples of proteins also. Thank you.